The Story of Buddha. Once upon a time, there was a king, Suddhodana, and queen, Mahamaya, who lived in a palace called Kapilvastu. Queen Mahamaya gave birth to a lovely baby boy at Lumbini Gardens named Siddharth. Sadly, the queen died 7 days later after giving birth. When Siddharth grew up, a wise man named Kaladevala informed the king he would witness things that would make him miserable and led him to flee to the jungle. As a result, the king never let Siddharth leave the royal walls. Siddharth was a bright and cheerful youngster who was compassionate and caring. Siddharth and his cousin Devadatta were walking one day. Devadatta observed a swan and shot it down on the spot. When Siddharth saw the injured bird, he was terrified. He drew the arrow from his body and applied some herbs to the wound. Devadatta wanted the bird as he shot him, but Siddharth declined. As a result, they processed to court. The wise man in the court said that the swan belonged to his person who saved it, not to the one who attempted to take its life. The prince matured into a young man. King Suddhodana wedded him to the lovely princess Yashodhara. The king thought that when Siddharth married, he would never leave his home. Siddharth, on the other hand, felt dissatisfied at the palace. "Let's go for a trip outside the palace," he asked his servant Chana one day. On his way, the prince came upon an elderly man who was hunched over. The prince had never encountered an elderly person before. He said, "What is that, Chana?" "This is an elderly gentleman," Chana observed. "One day, prince." "Well, I'll be elderly," the prince returned to his palace. Distraught, Siddharth went out again after a few days. This time, he encountered a sick guy who was wailing in agony. "What is that man crying?" Siddharth wondered, having never seen a sick person before. "He's unwell and due to serve pain. He is willing, Chana," responded Siddharth, was unhappy and returned to the palace. When Siddharth stepped outside the following time, he observed a group of people dragging a dead body. "One day we shall all die," Chana said. Siddharth, explaining that he was seeing a dead person. Siddharth knew his father had kept him in the palace to keep him safe from these dangers. Do we all have to get old, ill and die? He wondered to himself. Doesn't there seem to be any other option? Siddhartha left once more. He noticed a man with a shaved head, orange robes, and a bowl in his hand. This time, the man appeared to be in a good mood. Who is that man? He inquired of Channa. That's a sensible man who had a bond. Everything and gone to the wilderness to seek happiness, Channa said. Siddhartha pondered all he had witnessed. After that, he made the decision to leave home in search of happiness. So one night, while his wife and son Rahula were sleeping, Siddhartha secretly departed the palace with his devoted servant Channa. They went together till they reached the Enoma River. Siddhartha removed his imperial garments. There he handed Channa his clothes and his horse to return to the palace. He then donned an orange robe, shaved his long hair, and walked out holding a bowl. Do you know the road to happiness? Siddhartha inquired to each person he met. Nobody could tell him thought. Finally, he sat beneath a bodhi tree and attempted to solve the problem on his own. He started meditation. His journey came to an end after several days. People began to refer to him as Gautam Buddha, since he had matured into a knowledgeable man. All animals were cherished by Buddha, and he treated them all with compassion. Devadatta, his jealous counsel, once dispatched a wild elephant to attack Buddha. The elephants, on the other hand, knelt down to Buddha. When they saw him, Gautam Buddha had a large number of followers. He moved from place to place, sharing what he had learned with others. His pupils were divided into Sangha group. He advised that pleasure could be attained by being satisfied with what one had and treating all beings with kindness. When Buddha returned to Kapilvastu, he was welcomed by his father, wife and son, as well as many other Anand. One of his relatives became Buddha's devoted follower and cared for him. As he grew older, Buddha continued to preach for another 45 years. He was already 8 years old at that time. Finally, in Kusinara, he laid down beneath the sala trees and exhaled his last breath. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Thank you for watching.